Thank you for the introduction. So my talk will deal with the question, how FIFO is your concurrent FIFO queue? And this is joint work with my advisor Christoph Kirsch, Michael Lippertz, who sits also back. He implemented all the FIFO queues I compare in this talk, and Hannes Payer. So in this talk I will compare strict FIFO queue implementations and relaxed FIFO queue implementations, where strict FIFO queue implementations are linearizable with respect to a strict FIFO queue semantics, and relaxed FIFO queue implementations are not linearizable with respect to a strict FIFO queue semantics, but with respect to relaxed FIFO queue semantics. This means that elements may be treated in an out-of-order way. For example, a DQ operation may not return the oldest element of the queue, but one of the k oldest elements. So in this graph, you see the scalability of three strict FIFO queue implementations. A log-based queue, where a log manages the access to a simple linked queue. The non-blocking Michael Scott queue, which is the queue in the Java concurrency library. And the flat combining queue, which is more or less a log-based queue, but the thread which acquires the log also executes all the operations of those threads which do not get the log. So and as you can see, we ran a small micro benchmark where each thread enqueues and dequeues lots of elements. And so there is high contention on the queue. And as you can see, with an increasing number of threads, the operations per millisecond of all threads together actually do not increase much. And the peak performance here is with the Michael Scott queue at not more than 10 threads.
How many cores?
80 cores, or actually 40 cores with two hyperthreads each core. So this is now the results of a K5 queue, where K is the bound of the out of order treatment. So, and this K is independent of the number of threads. And you can already see that it scales twice as many threads as the strict ones.
Excuse me, are you going to say more about what you meant by oldest when you talked about what relaxed meant?
Well, the oldest is like the first, the element whose enqueue operation is executed first or takes place first is the oldest element in the queue. So, and with another relaxation, the scull queues, depending on, so these is a, they consist of a set of internal partial queues controlled by a load balancer. So there the relaxation depends on the number of queues, on the number of threads. And in this case, with the right load balancer, we can get actually near to linear scalability. Yes?
Do you have any rough idea of how many operations per millisecond you get with build synchronization on a unit processor?
Maybe you can ask this Michael Lippertz after the talk. The problem was now that some people said that, okay, how should we use these relaxed FIFO queues? They are not FIFO, so what kind of applications would you like to use them on? And we say that actually the relaxed FIFO queues can be even more FIFO than strict FIFO queue implementations. So, and I hope I can convince you in this talk that this is true. So consider the following example of a concurrent history, where we have four operations, NQA, NQB, DQB, DQA. In this example, the NQ operations do overlap. And overlapping operations can take effect in any order according to linearizability. So for example, we can say that the NQB operation takes place before the NQA operation. And then we have NQB, NQA, DQB, DQA, which is FIFO, behavior. So this is linearizable according to strict FIFO Q semantics. Now consider the second concurrent history where we just optimized the NQ operation, so they take less than half the time. But now the NQ operations do not overlap anymore. So we made a faster queue, but we reduced the overlaps, and therefore this is not linearizable. So why should this be better than that one? So here we have out of order execution of overlapping operations. Here we have out of order treatment of queue elements. In the end, it's both out of order behavior. So therefore, the key idea of the paper is that we record with various benchmarks or with concurrent histories and with various FIFOQ implementations and analyze these concurrent histories by only using the invocation times of all operations. And the reason for this is that ideally these operations would have taken effect with zero time anyway in the perfect implementation. And it's independent of the implementation and of the execution time of the operations. So if we consider again this example, we can just remove the execution times and thereby get what we call a zero time linearization. And then we see that the element B overtakes element A in this concurrent history. And for that we define element fairness now as the number of overtakings which take place in the zero time linearization. So in the paper we have more specific metrics which are called element age and element lateness, but I will not use them in this talk. So we run the following benchmark, a micro benchmark where all threads in parallel do for 10,000 iterations first NQ a unique element and then immediately DQ an element. And to control the contention on the queue, we added some number crunchings in between. So the benchmark in the beginning had a peak calculation of 2,000 iterations. Some details. So for the first 200 iterations, there are no DQs, just to avoid that we operate on an empty queue, because we wanted to measure the behavior of standard queue operations, not of queue operations which behave differently because they work on an empty queue. And in the last 200 iterations, we empty the queue so that we have element fairness for all elements. Well, we can measure the overtakings of all elements. So in this graph now, we measure element fairness per element. So how many overtakings take place per element on an increasing computational load. So the computational load is this number crunching. So the benchmark numbers in the beginning are actually for 2,000 iterations. So and we go up to 64,000 operations. And these are now the results for the strict FIFOQ implementations. So they are not zero, and the flat combining is really good. But the log-based queue and the Michael Scott queue, they are actually quite high. So this is about 30. And the K-FIFOQ now, it's right in the middle of that. So there's not much difference between the Michael Scott queue behavior, for example, and the K-FIFOQ behavior. And for the Scull queues, it's even more like the This is with a two random load balancing function. So there we have quite some overtakings because the Q does not provide much semantics anymore, so good bounds. But for when we use a global round robin load balancer, then we can actually be even better than any strict FIFO Q.
Now the 2RA one was the most scalable from before. Right?
Yes, that was. But the round robin Q even behave scaled better than all the others.
So if you think of fairness as like latency, we're seeing kind of a latency throughput trade-off between the black and the yellow lines.
Yes. So what we did by now, as a follow-up work to what I submitted, we were able to completely fill this gap. To have so, and also for the performance point of view, to get so what we did, we did not use then a global round robin, but a set of round robin counters, like 10 threads have one round robin, and the next 10 threads have another round robin, and with that kind of partitioning, we can actually fill the whole gap. And we can get nearly the performance of the orange line of the two random and are quite near to the element fairness of this line.
Excuse me, sorry.
Yes.
I don't want to derail you. If everyone else is with you and I'm not, that's fine. I can see the paper later. But I'm not quite sure what your experiment is, and I think if you explain how can they be better than strict FIFO again, then maybe I'll get it. But you know, if everyone goes like this, I'm perfectly happy not to understand that.
Okay.
I agree with you. Okay, thanks.
Okay, maybe I will repeat it.
Part of the problem is your graph is showing unfairness and yet it's labeled fairness.
Yeah. Keep in mind you have about eight more minutes or so.
So, what we do with element fairness is that we only consider the invocation times of operations.
The times at which they are invoked.
Yes.
Okay.
So for a Michael Scott queue, for example, the execution time of operations when the queue is under high contention is really long. And there will be lots of reordering of operations in this time. Whereas for the global round robin, for a skull queue, it's really short. There will not be any retries. And thereby, by just getting the element really fast into the queue, you get less reordering than you get by having strict FIFO queue semantics, but long execution times. Okay, so next is the question, how does this, for the strict FIFO queues, where do these values really come from? And so what we did was we measured just the out-of-order execution of single operations. And the observation is that the linearization points of these queues induce a strict order on the queue operations. So again, if we have this example, there are linearization points here. And now, considering the invocation times and the linearization points, we can say, just for these two operations, for example, that the operation NQB overtakes the operation NQA. And then again, we can count the number of overtakings. And so what we did here, we only did it for the strict FIFO queues, because we can really order the operations by the invocation points. By the linearization points. And we plan to do this also for the relaxed FIFO queues, but that's future work. And the way we did it was that first all threads do only NQ operations, and then we do sequential DQ just to get this order. And this is now the number of overtakings, it's the percentage of NQ operations which are overtaking other operations. And as you can see in the log-based queue and in the Michaels-Cott queue, nearly every operation, every NQ operation, overtakes another NQ operation. So there's no order at all. And for the number of the percentage of operations which get overtaken, you can see that the log-based, okay, there are some operations which get overtaken by all others, but not so many. But for the Michaels-Cott queue, there is still nearly every operation is overtaken by another operation. So there's really this huge amount of reorderings. So to conclude, we defined metrics to compare various FIFOQs implementation and relaxed queues and strict FIFOQs. And with the right workload, it can actually even be that relaxed FIFOQ implementations are more FIFO than strict implementations, which is a nice result. And in the future, we plan to measure operation fairness, so to see that they relaxed FIFO queues, so that we see that there is less reordering out of order execution of operations. And we plan to define element fairness so that it works also for other data structures like stacks. Thank you.
So one of the things you did was you put in some number crunching in between,
yes,
which would decrease the contention. Why bother? Wouldn't it be more interesting without the number crunching and full contention and just have them bang on it? Did you get different results when you did that, or what?
If you run with full pressure,
yeah,
on the queue without any number crunching,
yeah,
then nearly all, so also the SCAL queues with the round robin load balancer will not scale anymore. So you will, so we try to get some more realistic contention on the queue, probably, just to see, so we are, the queues at least up to some number of threads scale.
So when you say realistic, did you tune the amount of number crunching so that you got publishable results, or did you go out and measure the actual amount of contention on real queues and real?
Well, results for a variety of queues.
Yes, so we have the results for different number of, so only the performance numbers were on just 2,000, but here I have 0 up to 64.
Sorry, I had missed.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, that's good.
But it's just a micro benchmark and most likely not the most realistic one, because one thread enqueues and dequeues, it's not even a producer-consumer.
Got it, but still very blind. Other questions out there? Sorry if I usurped.
Yes.
So you are familiar with elimination stacks, elimination queues, and these kind of things?
So these are just six implementations. So in the paper there are...
I'm just asking so I can set up my question. If you don't know, we need to take it offline, so...
Oh, well, I'm not an expert with these queues, but we measured them.
Yes. Let's talk later. It's going to take a little longer, sorry.
Any other questions out there? Well, thanks again. Really cool work.
Thank you.
Being less deterministic makes it more deterministic.
Yeah, it depends on where you get this non-determinism from the semantics of the queue. Or from the out of order execution.